on first inspection, that minute hand is bent terribly to compensate probably for that it was not striking on the 12. It was probably striking on the 11. It just feels as though something got bent one way or the other throughout the years. Back away a little bit here. Took off the pins. I have the dial sitting on a piece of bubble wrap. Took off the other pins. Here's the back of the dial with the movement mount. Nothing too unusual yet, just old. Some wire holding in on the moon dial. We now have the dial off of the unit, and I'm beginning to find a bunch of surprises from previous repairs, which should be making this quite interesting. Not sure why all these great wheels are as loose as they are. It could be worn holders or whatever. We'll be breaking into that in a little bit and repairing it as things go on. It's been bushed before. I believe you'll be able to see a bush right there in the center. First thing we'll be doing is taking off the verge here. Get that out of the way so we can lay this unit flat on the back plate. Very old brass. This is not the type of brass that you want to put in an ultrasonic cleaner. This one you want to clean by hand. It won't shine it up because old brass just simply didn't shine like the new type of brass. This is like battleship brass. And the last thing you want to do is to use an ultrasonic cleaner because the ammonia will be forced into the crevices of the old brass, because old brass is not meant. It's not like new brass. New brass, cleaner cannot get inside. It simply is cleaning the outside. On the old brass, it has a whole lot of gaps and cracks and crevices, and that allows the ammonia to go inside the brass, and it starts to leach out the feel some grooves on that. This pivot has to be resurfaced. Gets most of the grime right off of the wheels, and they look pretty good. The next thing, you can take all of the wheels and just simply put them in a lathe, or you can do it by hand if you want. Just get a polishing stick that you can buy at Merit's or Time Savers, and just kind of polish them up a little bit in a lathe that goes a lot faster. We want to put the minute hand in first. The minute arbor, I mean. And then put the strike side in. We got the spring for that. Now we need to install the hand. Advance it until it just drops off. Oh, you may not be able to see that. I'm also going to be pointing the minute hand at the 12 o'clock mark, which happens to be, this is one of those centered holes right here. Right here, the little center. I continued putting on the rest of the equipment. This little spring bar over here, which acts as a ratchet to lock in the calendar gear. And I hope that you've been listening, because this clock doesn't have a calendar gear.
On the test bench, I put the pendulum on and went ahead and checked out the beat on it. It was off, well, in the level state that it's in right now, it was off by 400 points according to the time tracks, which means it was really out of beat, and it would sound like tick-tock, 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 like that, instead of a nice even tick-tock, tick-tock. Having one of these time tracks really helps it along. Let me show you what it sounds like. Nice and even. And another clock brought back to life. An old, old English 12-case clock with second hand, minute and hour hand, moon dial, Jacob Craft, Shepherdstown.